Well, I'm seeing my cats, well, particularly Bear. I got no idea if the overheads or surrounds are going to work. So, because Bear, so I got to do a sound rehearsal check procedure. Typical projectionist sort of instinct things used to do. Okay, the overheads are working. I could tune them up a bit. Probably had a different movie on playing before, so I'd probably have to retune the levels. No, I've seen this move, so I'm not really that much of interest to it. Oh, it cuts right into the movie. I thought they were going to do one of those Atmos trailer things like they do most on some Lionsgate. A couple of movies I got. Deep Seahorse Horizon and... the other one, Midray, yeah, the other Roland Emmerich, Midray, yeah, that had a Dolby what's it on it thing. I think it's got the same re-recording mixer on this. Gregory Russell, who did 13 hours. Making telephone calls and then got kicked out of the Academy Awards for telephony lobbery. Yeah. Well, if you don't abide by the rules, you get kicked out. So it's that simple, isn't it? He got a little bit too greedy, I think, a bit hasty, because he never won an Academy Award, And he's been mixing for decades, even before... Black Rain, that movie with Michael Douglas, and didn't know about all this. And I think after a few more years or so, I think he kind of like was too hungry for winning an award. But some people like start, there's no big deal in it. He's got a job, he should be fortunate with that. Not care about win a bloody Academy Award. I mean, the film might not be that good of a mix. I mean, why didn't he get nominated for Midray? I mean, Midray had a good sound. This is almost a bit like Gravity. But not as. So a little bit of like a Gravity. Bear, will you keep your nose out of the grapes? So, oi, Bear, you don't like grapes. You don't like grapes. I'm not running on projector. I'm not interested. But that some of this looks... a little bit different to Gravity. In some way, it's trying to copy. Some of that looks okay, and some of it doesn't. But then, how many people have been inspected? But then you got to look at actual live TV NASA footage and all that, and how things looked. And I think the floodlighting on the suits and that look accurate. Oh, boom, got space sound, in space sound. I've only got the centre channel playing at the moment. I'm only in Dolby True mode, so I haven't switched on the overhead. Should be active now. Turn the centre channel off, turn the fader up. Oh, this movie utilises height 1, height 2, height 3. So I've got the other height channels muted. And the other one's moving around. I can hear height number 2 above me. It's moving around. over my dog channels, my overhead dog channels. I'm the only home cinema that uses this. Not even a dub stage has got this sort of setup. And I'm matrixing off the decodering with the SA10s. So the sound, there's speakers down here, just one directly below, plus another below surround, another one over there, and then one over up front, and up front, and at the back of the room. And they kind of give a circle effect, vertical circle effect. Because it's not just here and above, it's because at the end of the day, it's a gimmick, all right? Otherwise, you could put these overhead size overhead speakers, whatever, you could put them down alongside with the regular, and you know what? Wouldn't be anyone that wouldn't, and any no one would be the wiser, you know? You wouldn't know, because most sometimes you think you're hearing overhead surround. But really, most times you're hearing your sidewall surrounds because of the way they're positioned. And you know, unless you actually do proper testing through pink noise and frequency test tones to listen how a sine wave tone sounds. And, you know, from where you're sat, sometimes the tone can sound like it's above you, down at this level or below, you know. That's just the physicality of the tone to where the speaker's placed, and you can move the speaker in a different position while listening to that tone that you think you're perceiving it in this, and then move that speaker's position. It might gradually change position slightly. Oh, some of the overhead is not too bad during the opening. I'm going to turn the other overheads on. Let's turn the other ones on. Turn the fader up a bit. So the mix levels up here for the other channels, and the other mix levels here for the surrounds. Yeah. I did recalibrate this recently, so I'd have to double check and double check with the pink noise. So it goes with multi stereo channel mode. And you use the REM, so it generate the pink noise, so it goes to all channels equal level that I would see on the VU meters. And yeah, I'm just checking these levels. That's on the back surround there. That's on the back surround. And then it gradually pans and moves and shifts with different. So, yeah, I'm not sure what it's going to utilize in this movie. Is it going to use gravity like DME on all channels? Oh, I can hear a bit of dialogue of a TV. Overhead. Now she's looking. All right, she's looking upstairs. All right, that's a good positioning. That's a good positioning. But there's something a little bit missing with that sound. It sounded too clinical. So if I put on the other channels, I might hear a difference with reflectivity or acoustic or psychoacoustic. But yeah, that TV sound in that location position. But something about the geography of the, you know, because her eye line sight is looking up the stairs, so it wouldn't really be in that overhead. It really should be a little bit more over this angle position, because I can tell by the angle, the incline of a staircase, and so really, it's a little bit off target. The mixers and director have got it a little bit off target. Should be a little bit more over on that overhead surround. But, you know, it is what it is.